takže vyzerujte vadí, teďkrát si asi do útok a teďkrát se vyhlasí do sprintem rád.
Thank you. So conditioning, specific conditioning on coaches. Of course, as a basketball coaches, we should take care of conditioning because in today basketball, specific basketball conditioning become probably one of the most important segments of preparation. So, we should understand first of all our priorities. Because basketball is not same like football, like volleyball, they have different conditioning for different sports.
Že basketbal není jako ostatní sporty.
I said yesterday that scientific research showed that in basketball we have around 1000 different moves.
Včera vysvětloval, že se to musíme věnovat, protože v basketbalu máme tisíce různých pohybů, tisíce různých navázání pohybů.
Our goal in the practice is to copy all activities from the game and to find specific drills in order to avoid injuries, first of all, to prepare well players and to be effective to be on the top of performance when we do.
My sme měli připravovat kondiční cvičení tak, že vlastně je budeme používat segmenty ze hry, aby jsme měli dobrou prevenci vlastně zranění. Přípravu vlastně posunutí těch hráčů v té speciální kondici.
But of course we should understand that we cannot do all the conditioning stuff in one practice. As we said, methodology for basketball skills, we should have also schedule, practice plan and program and periodization also for conditioning skills. Because with conditioning skills and conditioning abilities, we can miss more than basketball. We can miss shape, we can make injuries because this is very risky.
Musíme stejně tak, jako máme pro basketbalový trénink, plánujeme ho, máme nějakou periodizaci toho, co chceme naučit, to sami musíme, o tom sami musíme přemýšlet, co se týče speciální kondice.
For example, if we are doing some sprint, speed or agility drills in the middle of the practice, after that, if you are doing some aerobic endurance drills, this is should practice, so we are going to cover stuff, it doesn't make sense to do this.
Musíme přemýšlet, v jaký části tréninku specifické basketbalové kondiční drily zařadíme, protože když je zařadíme doprostřed toho tréninku, když předtím jsme dělali drily, které spíš vedly k vytrvalosti, tak nemá smysl vůbec ty specifický rozvoj.
I'm sure that you know that, but coaches, mostly injuries happen because of bad practice plan, not because of overload.
Myslím, že většina zranění je z toho, že špatně naplánovaný ať už trénink, anebo ten mikrocyklus tréninkový, než to, že by hráči byli přetíženi.
For example, if we want to work on some physical abilities which, for which we need fresh body, like speed, agility, coordination, new drills, we should work on those abilities in the main part, the beginning of the main part of the practice or at the beginning of the week when players are fresh, when they are not tired.
Důležitý, aby jsme ty schopnosti, které chceme posouvat, týkají se rychlosti, rychlostní vytrvalosti, explozivní síly, aby jsme je dělali v momentě, když jsou ještě odpočat, to znamená hned po rozcvičení anebo a hlavně taky na začátku.
If you want to work on anaerobic endurance, lactate endurance or aerobic endurance, we can do it also in the end of the practice because endurance is practically resistance of time.
Vlastně, když chceme ale zase rozvíjet nějakou vytrvalost, tak prosím vytrvalost, můžeme to dělat úplně nějak speciálně, protože vlastně chceme vybudovat rezistenci
We should understand that most important physical abilities for basketball players are explosive power, lower body, flex.
Musíme si uvědomit, že nejdůležitější pro basketbalisty je koncentrácia, bez pozemní síla, ručná síla, spodní časť tela
speed, agility, quickness.
Další, nohou, rýchlosť, změny stěru, změny všech pohybů na hřiši
So, other skills, of course, we need also aerobic endurance, even if basketball is not aerobic sport, because aerobic endurance is foundation for specific anaerobic endurance, and aerobic endurance is important because of recovery time. Môžeme
mít obecnou vytrvalosť, že to je základ, preto aby sme mohli vybudovať tie najdôležitejšie veci, to znamená rýchlosť, vytrušnosť.
Another stuff, another thing which I should mention to you, is related to conditioning, especially youth program, is to take care of sensitive zones or windows of trainability for specific skills. This is probably more topic for conference room, but I will mention just a couple of sentences.
Chcem říct jenom pár věd o tom, kam zařazovat ty kondiční tréninky a vlastně v jakém rytmu, aby mělo svůj účinek.
So what is meaning?
Oh,
this is something else. So, for example, what is meaning of windows of trainability or sensitive zones? There are specific...
I'm sorry, just explain. Já jsem původně nerozuměl. Bude mluvit o sensitive windows. To jsou vlastně období, kdy rozumíme u těch hráčů, je největší možnost rozvoje rychlosti a tak dále. Období od do.
If we miss that windows of trainability, it's not possible to arrive at the peak of the performance, even if you are doing a lot of stuff like that.
Jedině, když my nerozvíjíme v tom věku ty věci, které máme rozvíjet, velice těžko se nám to rozvíjí.
So, for example, window of trainability for coordination is from 6 to 11.
Od 6 do 11 let je vlastně...
So, that means that we should work on basketball skills. They should learn everything, passing, dribble, shooting, open step, cross step, all the stuff, because they are able to learn new skills from 6 to 11.
Od 6 do 11 je vlastně ideální okno sensibility pro rozvoj koordinace, znamená dribbling a tak dále, všechny ty naše basketball skills, basketball dovednosti.
After that, at age of 11, girls also 1 year later, they start to grow up. So probably in 3 years they can grow up 20, 30 centimeters, of course they cannot be good in coordination.
Samozřejmě potom, kdy je po tom 11. roku, kdy je akcelerace růstová, tak se velice těžce v tomto období pracuje právě na koordinaci a na nácviku těch skills.
As a coaches we should understand, we should know theoretical stuff about that, and we should know that in that next stage, let's say for girls, from 10 to 13, 14, boys 11 to 15, is not good time to develop coordination. But it doesn't matter, we should work on coordination, having in mind that we will use that work, we will get fruits in the later part of their development, because this is normal, because they are big, they are not so good in coordination, but we should keep working on coordination, having in mind that this is normal stop, normal plateau in learning.
Důležitý, abychom si uvědomili, těch dívek 10 do 13, 14 let, chlapců od 11 do 14, 15, že se nám bude hůř rozvíjet ta koordinace kvůli tomu skoku růstovému, ale musíme se tomu také věnovat a nemůžeme to přestat úplně dělat. Musíme být trpělivý v tom, že se nám to v tomto věku neučí rychle nebo jsou nešikovní, ale určitě se to v nich objeví v momentě, kdy přeskočí vlastně to do toho.
It's very similar situation with speed, because speed is straightly connected with coordination. So it's same with the superability from 6.
To samé s rychlostí, protože byl tím se spjatý s koordinací,
So that means that even in age of mini basket, 7, 8, 9 years old, we can work on speed. But here we have another technical limitation.
Samozřejmě můžeme už v tom věku, kdy jsou mini basketbalisti pracovat, měli by se pracovat na rychlosti, ale jsou tam zase určitelné.
So we cannot push kids 8, 9 years old to work full speed skills which they are not good technical. So always we have methodology. Good technique, repetition, intensity. never put intensity in front of technique.
No, měli bychom tu intenzitu, měli bychom chyt do nejrychlejšího pohybu, aniž bychom předtím s nima nedělali techniky. To znamená, nesmí nám intenzita přeskočit ty věci, jako je technika běhu.
And another stuff, just theoretical stuff before to start to run drills regarding speed as a one of most important conditioning skills for basketball players, that we should understand which kind of speed basketball players need.
Měli bychom rozumět, jaký druh rychlosti potřebují basketbalisté.
Usain Bolt, one of the best athletes ever, okay, he don't need his sprinter. When we are saying speed, you think Bolt. But Bolt is sprinting in the one direction, straight line, and he don't need to stop. And he achieved maximal speed after 50 meters. So this is absolutely not related to basketball.
Samozřejmě rychlost, jako má Bolt, je sprintuje jenom po přímé dráze a musí brzdit, se naší rychlosti basketbalovou nerovná.
So practically this meaning of this is that basketball players never arrive on the highest speed in a run. Why? Because basketball court is 28 meters. We need 50 meters to start to run, not we, best sprinters in the world.
Nepotřebujeme nejlepší sprintery na světě, protože ty tu rychlost získávají na určité dráze. My máme jenom velice omezený prostor toho kurtu, takže my vyvíjíme jinou.
So basketball speed, start, stop, change direction and move. Frontally, laterally, diagonally, this is basketball. And we should work on that kind of speed.
Že my bychom měli pracovat na tomto druhu rychlosti. Sprint, zastavení, slide, pospěch, pospát.
Especially because most of the injuries happen when players are going to stop activities. When they land or when they change direction, injuries happen.
Většinou, pokud to není rozvinuté nebo nerozvinuté, tam je nejvíce zranění. Co to kdy hráči brzdí, kdy doskakují, kdy změní směr.
And another stuff, jumping ability. This is related with explosive power and flex.
Další věc je skokanská schopnost, to znamená explosivní pušná síla.
Most of the coaches, when we are working on jumping ability, we are going to use two legs jumps.
Většina trenérů využívá to, že se skáče sobě.
That must be, not at the beginning. Because this is foundation for one leg jumps. Why? Because in basketball coaches we have just two situations when we are going to use two leg jumps. Jump shot and defensive rebound. In all other situations we use just one leg.
Situace, kdy máme odraz obou nohou, to je při jump shot, při střelbě z výskoku, anebo při obraném doskakování.
92% of injuries in basketball in last three Italy, Spain, Turkey, 10 countries, they analyze how many injuries happen. 92% of injuries happen on one leg activities. So also because of injury prevention, we should work much more on one leg.
92% všech zranění těch zemí, co jste asi rozuměli, žili analýzu, tak vzniklo při aktivitě hráče nebo hráčky na jedné noze. To znamená, my musíme rozvíjet tyto ty aktivity a věnovat se.
When to start? Immediately.
Kdy začal?
Minibasket. Minibasket. It's a crazy coach from Serbia. Oh, minibasket. They can jump over the line. They can use jump rope. Top players, hardless like this, chairs, boxes, everything. But we should start in mini basket to create, to make to work on injury prevention, on explosive power. Using lights, why not? Okay, let's go now to through the drills. I will run drills, most of drills with ball, and I will explain which kind of abilities we are going to develop. Beginning of the practice, dribble or warm-up, and also can be aerobic endurance drill if you're going to work 15-20 minutes. Let's go, Ivan, organize it. Come on. Ivan, three laps. Come on, let's go. One by one. When first man arriving in the second spot, second one is catching. Come on, let's go. Left hand, if you work for different dribble skills, and how we measure our movement. Four corners, different dribble skills. simple drills, fast break again. Different way of finishing with simple fast break drill condition. I hope you can do it today. Just like one, okay. Just one over there like this. Come, let's go. Push. Come, sir. Simple. Fast break drill. Stay here. You stay here before. Put the ball on the glass. Go to the open over there. Fast forward. Come on, pass to team. I don't want to discuss about fast break, how to open, which passing technique, positioning. Dribble inside, run over there. You should pass to team. He should score without dribble immediately. When you score, you get rebound, you pass to him, you are going to make two laps. First finishing, just lay up without dribble. Immediately next group is starting. When he scores, he's coming on the side. You receive the ball.
Get over, come on, now, right again, left, three more to the right. Come on, let's go, rebound!
endurance. As you can see, we cannot travel here with endurance, we can travel with passes. They cannot make two good passes. I count in one moment from 10 with efficient space score twice. So coaches, we should go back to the elementary school. With medical ball we can do this. Okay, this is not a problem. After 2 weeks they will get better. Make groups of 3 players, another 3 and 0, part of the group. 1, 2, 3, ball here. Ball here, make groups, make groups. Ball here, stay on the side, side, side. Side. Okay. Come, come, ball in the middle, ball in the middle. Let's go. Okay, we are doing this. Ivane, pass the ball. No dribble. 3 passes. You are going to run. So, you are going to pass to him, pass back to me. So, him, outside, outside of this court, not our outside. So, I am going to pass here, you are going to score, no dribble. Middle man, you are going to sprint around this court and to sprint back. You get the foul shooter, you go outside, pass to him, you pass to him, and you sprint to get rebound over here. No triple passes condition. Under 16 heavy ball, 2 kilos, because we should work on explosive power of shoulders. Body core, explosive power of shoulders with medical balls. 2 kilos, no problem, absolutely for under 16. Let's go. Good pass. Outside of court. Let's go. Sprint. Come on, pass. We are not happy because 3-0 we are missing shots. Again, same group again. This is four guys. Come on. Now we go to three. Next group, let's try to score every time. Come on. Pass. Go back. Sorry. No oxygen. And mistakes. This is normal, but they are going to get better day by day, week by week. Don't worry about it. But you should stop. You cannot say now they are going to miss pass when they are missing layup 3-0. How many points they will score in 5-5 when they are missing 3-0? Come on, let's go. Come on. This is good group in the number. Come on. Let's go. Next. Go.
Thank you. Come on, come on. Rebound, Na
practices towards the health of 245
miles.
If you remember, 2-3 years ago, Golden State Cleveland, when LeBron James made that block for Iguodala, who was sprinting over there to make block in the last second of the game. Seventh game, he was on ESPN, they count, he was 4 meters behind player with ball, and he sprint in the last game, in the last second to stop. This is top of one. Okay. Systems. Okay. They will make one set. I don't want to kill 4 players. After each set, they are going to change. But usually, in the practice, I'm not going to change. So one group is making. Let's make like this. Other group, 4 players. Come here. Somebody here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on. Come on. Everybody. Okay, you are going to do this. Okay, you are going to make stay in the line. Stay in the line. Everybody? Okay. You are going to make defensive slide 20 seconds. Every time you should go out of the paint. With 2 legs. Here and here. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Jump.
One player here, please.
Okay, you have 20 seconds.
First one, we are going to make agility here, skizzle. Okay? Yone, 20 seconds, let's make like this. You are going to make defensive slide, slide around the cone, and move back with 2 legs in the middle circle. Only one position. Let's make on one position 20 second work, 20 second rest. Let's make 3 sets on one position.
Kako zvanice Tabata system, znači 20 sekundi vracujemo, 20 sekundi odi u UMF, 3 kola.
Na,
vidite niste stani.
With top level of the players, you can do 6 sets, 20 second work, 10 second rest. This is very good.
Sa seniorima na špičku urovni, system je 20 sekundi vrace, 10 sekundi rest.
6 sets, after that 3 minutes break, and after that 2 minutes.
6 kola, potom musi 3 minute odiha.
Okay, be ready, we are going to make 3 sets, 20 minutes. Okay, ready?
Hlavní části,
If you are going to make sprints after this, you will destroy your place. Never.
I will
do some sprints just because I want to show to you, but never do it to the practice. After an aerobic lactate endurance, no sprints. Because it doesn't make sense. It seems like cow is going to give you milk, and after that, keep the milk. No way. Okay?
On teďka ukáže ještě nějaké cvičení, které jsou teda rychlostní, ale to, co vlastně dělá o takových
lidí.
Když bylo následovat kompenzace, kam dám v tom tréninku, se o to bez nedá rozdělat.
This drill is very simple, very easy. You can do it also in any basket, with ball or without the ball. It stands and jumps, with one leg jump, whatever you want. Okay, come on, four players. Four players with ball. Because you want to work on conditioning as much as possible with ball. Okay, you stay here, next player over there, out of the ball. Here, you stay like this, okay, opposite. Here, okay. We are going to run with rebound, this is speed, coordination, injury prevention, because they should stop. You are going to catch player in front of you. Okay, this stuff is there. Okay? Ready? I like to use a lot of conditioning with shooting drills. team or individual drills or station method. One group of players, one basket, some drill, another group over there. So let's make it easier.
Test for them. Every drill is challenge, every drill is selection.
if some of them is going to be three times, okay, I will play diamond for you in the last set. They should deserve to be shooters. They are not shooters because father is manager or mother is nice man. So we don't want this. So now, option, just make one lap. Lateral jumps, and after the dribble, shot, fake shot for three.
Conditioning shooting.
Because I want my players to be ready to work
a lot. Jedno je si to jenom kondiční trénink, basketbalový trénink. Já používám specifický střelecký cvičení. Specifickou kondici. Okamžitě musí reagovat. Má první krok v expozici. Face to the basket. Come on, come on. Not this, not back to the
basket, face to the basket every time.
No change, bravo.
Okay, enough. Last one. Come on, next. Oh, bravo, very good. So, when I was playing 2 million years ago, I finished practices with 23 point shots in a row with this dribble. It's very tough, sometimes 20 minutes, sometimes 2 minutes, sometimes 1 hour. 23 points in a row. If you miss 18, you should start from the beginning. It's terrible. But you can arrive. If you are working every day, you can arrive that way. Okay, now we are doing something else. Agility, defense, and slide. Okay, you are going to move your ability. You are going to move like this. Lateral, cone to cone. When coach passes to you, you are going to shoot and you go. You are going to just take a look. Come on.
Okay.
Okay, bravo, sì. Grazie. I like to use very much Jeff in the shooting drills.
Často se viac stolicu položil za specifické cvičenia pre šutere.
Why coaches? Because when players are going to shoot, you are saying stay low, stay low, stay low. They will say yes, coach, they are never going. So if you are going to put chair here, when they are going to pick up the ball, of course they will need to flex. Break, but they should go down.
Flex in noha. A nije začinak prvi drugi svistrati mi noha. Stolička, počuja me, gdje su prijatelji igrača, pak idu do refleksije, spustiti se nisko bi valiti nadje u prve ruke.
If you are going to play flex offense, you can combine with this. Ok, let's start from here.
Možete spraviti breakdown sa svojih utočnih sistema, napravo da prate flex utok, ali go.
Ok, you are going to make three over them. They are not three. Step six. Sprint over there, bring the ball for the chair.
Simulujemo situaciju flexa, screen for screener.
Simulujemo flow, also a sprint.
Polovka na toj ću.
Cut, four, just one, full sprint. Stay down, stay down, take the ball, shoot, bravo, now, next.
Thank you.
cut. Let's make, of course, we can change side. Now, close up, sprint, sprint, just shoot for three. Get the shot, 3 points.
Treninga, alebo na koncu tižna, učitelj nije v sudježnom ciklu.
48 sati pre utakmice raditi tonizaciju sa plyometrijskim vežbama, isti high intensity low volume.
4 ciklusa vodim pred zapasom, se može robiti teško atletske cvičanje teškom plyometrijom, je visoki intensitet, ali mali volume.
Tipična greška trenera,
klasička giba trenera je
u takmičarskom periodu,
sudježnom ciklusu,
smanje i obim i intenzitet.
Smanje aj volumen, aj intenzitet.
I onda se to igrači, i onda se igrači izduvaju kao balon i ne vede ništa.
Potom hrač se pitlaši kao balon i ne može nič, lebo dakle, imamo intenzitet.
U takmičarskom periodu, neposredno pred utakmicu, naročito 3-4 dana, smanjiti volumen, ali držati intenzitet.
2-3 dana pred zapas, treba skratiti ekstenzitet, ali udržati čast intenziti, a bi hrali po skupni.
Naravno, high intensity drills,
ali
short.
High intensity drills, ali kraće.
10-15 minutes, 20 minutes. And you should count also basketball drills as a high intensity.
I treba početati, a iz basketballovim cvičanjima 3x3, 4x4, 5x5, ako od cvičanja visokog intenziteta pred zapas.
Dakle, kada razmišljamo o kondiciji, when we are thinking about conditioning, we should consider metabolic zone in which we are going to work.
Znači, da odpozor na metabolicku zonu, a ako treba pracovati.
And in the end of the story, because all the players are going to hate conditioning coaches.
Na koncu kaže igrač, ne znaš na svoju kondičnog trenera.
Try to be smart.
Budite mudri.
Last day, last practice, or last 2 days before the game.
Poslali trening, ali dan dva pred zapas.
Try to give to the players drills which they like and drills in which they are good.
Pokušajte selektovati cvičenja ktore oni maju rad i ktorima su dobri, a bismo ne vitvarali ambicioznost.
Especially playoff time.
Specijalno playoff.
Because in playoff time you cannot change anything in 2 days between the games, but you can build confidence if you are going to give to players drills in which they are good.
Već odirano misliš da kad pride playoff, da budeš prečitan, a začinu vimišljati i ne veći će su robili počas sroka, čo je giba, treba račun pustiti do nekakve konforne zone, ali držati
vimisi. In youth program, because they are growing up, especially girls between 9 and 12, and boys between 11 and 14, you should consider that it's better to have fresh bodies than overtrained.
Znači, kako mladeš za kategorija, trebaš ti ist za veci mišljenje koje treba imati fresh body.
Odihnuti
tijelo, ako dao to ono ono.
I zapamtite da je, kao sam rekao na početku, najčešće uzrok povreda loša kombinacija i loš izbor vežbi, a ne povrede.
Najčešće dovod zranjenja igrača je zla selekcija cvičenja, a nije silni intenzitet.
For example, they are going to work on Tabata method, anaerobic endurance, and after that,
znači, ne može ista bata, a potom agilnost gdje idemo, zautačamo na te sensitive zone.
And try to use ball as more as possible, as much as possible, because it's...
Uživajte lopte, kažete zvišnje na tih kondičnih, a vi samo za nebude.
As you can see, I show you just a couple of drills, of course, it's up to you to develop different drills.
Samo za nebude vela zvišnje, koje vi možete i sami vibrati, selektor.
But always consider metabolic zone to which you are
working. Žitava pozor na metabolicu zonu na kojoj se
prilazi. And respect rest night between two repetitions in each metabolic.
Respektovati pauzu na isto ako
trenutku. To finish, as I said, speed, 1 to 5 or 1 to 12, work and rest.
Pomer aktivita od 1-4, 1-12.
Anaerobic lactate endurance 1-1 or 1-0.5. You can run around the gym 12 minutes, but you can make also this first drill, this rhythm 20 minutes. It's better for players to run and to make 200 changes of direction.
Specijalno pred mladežnicke trenere, a vi ne stacali čas, imate limitovani nekakav volumen, a stup do hale, a bi to malo smisla, lepše je použiti na mjesto živi. Zoberete long bad, smisla, že robi tako to kardio, a aerobno zatjaž, cez tehnické úlohy na začiatku tréninga s loptou.
Adjust also according to the conditioning program nutrition, if it's possible.
Dajte pozor na metabolizm.
So if you want to work on muscle hypertrophy, of course you should eat more proteins. If you are going to work on agility, speed, carbohydrates, short carbohydrates with low glycemic index.
Low glycemic index, kada ide o hipospadljivosti, smanjenju rekonstruktivnosti.
Because we should get petrol for the right activities.
Treba imati gas za spravne
aktivnosti. Because airplane is not flying with diesel. Kerozin, we need kerozin for airplane. So it's like this. Of course, this is big picture, we can talk. That's 10 days, but I just touch all the aspects because you should understand that even if you're going to do great conditioning job on court and out of the court, it's very important what the players are doing outside of the court.
Stagistu dole, što robite vi s njima počas treningu, na igrisku aquactivitu, aki je plana program, ešte možda je dole što ako oni stravija, ako je njihov čas u ovom času.
Because let's say that kids that age, how many practices per week they are making? 3 times, 4 times, huh? Well, how many times per week?
9 times, 4 weeks.
9 practices per week?
Per week, 4 or 5.
4. So let's say 8 hours per week.
So 8 hours is close per week. And you can see how much hours.
So let's say that they are making 2 hours every day. 22 hours are influencing a lot of their performance, much more than practice if they're eating something bad. If
the training is about 2 hours a day, it's more than 22 hours, you can have a better improvement.
More information for them than for you. If you want to become champion, you should behave as a champion before you become champion.
If you want to be a champion, you should be able to be a champion before you become champion.
I da završim ovu kliniku sa vama, da ne bude da mi ja dajem neke savete, ali kao treneri morate da imate visoke aspiracije.
Ako treneri trebate imati visoke cilje, visoke aspiracije.
Jer, što kaže jedna lepa izreka.
Jedna stara izreka.
Pucaj na mesec.
Strelaj na mesec.
Ako promašiš, pašćeš među zvezde.
Ako ne trafiš, budeš među zvijezda.
So thank you very much for your time. I hope it was useful for you.